This is how it looks on social media. And behind me, that's the reality. And we are talking about the Northern Lights. And today I'm going to show you 9 misconceptions people have about them. We are here outside the Explore Norway HQ in Oslo, Norway. And our first misconception is that they look on the photos exactly like in reality.
Unfortunately, that's not the case. Our eyes aren't sensitive to color in low light, so the northern lights appear grayish with just a hint of green. Sometimes there is a very bright outburst and they become a vivid green, but that usually lasts 30 to 40 seconds at most. A typical display might last anywhere from 15 minutes to a few hours, with these bright moments scattered throughout. Modern cameras are sensitive to color and these photos use longer exposure times, usually several seconds. Plus, the images are edited in Photoshop to make the northern lights stand out more. We do that too. So here is what we saw this evening. We ran the camera in time-lapse for over 30 minutes. The green color is clearly visible, and also that it is moving. Just for reference, that's how it looks in the other direction. By the naked eye, you could only guess what was happening. The sky in the northern direction was slightly brighter. Most people would have thought it was clouds with light pollution. Unfortunately, no bright burst happened in the hour I stood there.
The second misconception is that they are, obviously like today, always green. That's not the case.
The northern lights appear in different colors depending on which atoms are excited in the upper atmosphere, similar to how neon tube lights work. It's usually green, but sometimes violet. During very strong events, they can even appear red in southern latitudes such as Central Europe. However, you will only see these colors with your own eyes when the aurora is particularly intense, such as during those 30 to 40 second outbursts we mentioned. The rest of the time, they appear grayish to the naked eye, but colorful to cameras. If you see pictures with colors like yellow or rainbow colored auroras, that's AI bullshit.
The third misconception is that you need an expensive camera, like I have, but that's not completely true.
The most important accessory is actually a tripod. Without one, the type of camera you have is irrelevant. You can use your smartphone to achieve decent results. However, to get the best results, you need a camera that you can configure manually and that can record in RAW. Even the cheapest DSLR or mirrorless camera will produce better results than your phone. It doesn't need to be the newest model. This Nikon DSLR, which is over 10 years old, will take better pictures than my smartphone. This is because smartphones have small sensors with lots of pixels, whereas DSLRs usually have large sensors with larger pixels. Large pixels work better in low light conditions.
The fourth misconception is that they always happen in winter, but today is October and that's not yet winter.
The northern lights are present all year round, but during the summer months it is too bright to see them. Even when the sun is below the horizon, it still illuminates the sky. The sky background is then brighter than the northern lights. In southern Norway, it's possible to see the northern lights from mid-August to late April. In northern Norway, they can be seen from the beginning of September to the beginning of April.
The fifth misconception is that you need to go to Tromsø. But as you see, I'm not in Tromsø right now.
The northern lights can be seen all over Norway. But if you want the best chance of seeing them, you should be in northern Norway. Tromsø is popular because it's easy to reach and offers a variety of activities. However, Tromsø doesn't guarantee clear skies. The last time we were there, the aurora appeared every night, but the clouds obscured the view 3 out of 4 nights. There are places with statistically better weather, such as Abisko in Sweden, which is known as the blue hole in the sky, where the shape of the mountains causes clouds to dissipate more frequently. However, it's more difficult to reach, and there isn't much there besides a ski resort. The truth is that you're booking months in advance and the weather in Norway is unpredictable. It's a gamble wherever you go. Tromsø just makes the gamble more worthwhile.
And the sixth misconception is something similar, that you cannot see them from southern Norway. But like I just showed, it's fully possible.
As I said before, the northern lights can be seen everywhere in Norway, but they need to be strong enough to be seen further south. This strength is measured by the KP index. The higher the number, the further south they can be seen. In Kristiansand, for example, you would need a KP index of around 7. In Oslo, around KP 5. In Ålesund and Trondheim, around KP 4. And in Tromsø, even a KP index of 2 is often enough. So what does this mean in practice? The higher KP index are rarer. As such, the northern lights appear more seldom, so you see them less often in these areas. In Kristiansand, for example, you might see them once a year. In Oslo, 2 to 3 times a year. In Ålesund, they appear once or twice a month. In Trondheim, they appear 2 to 3 times a month. In Tromsø, they appear nearly every day. However, these numbers can change based on solar cycles, which repeat every 11 years. So don't come to southern Norway just to see them. If you're lucky enough to see them, just enjoy it. It's very rare that people go far away to watch them, unless a really big event is announced. Most of the time the pictures are taken from people's yards, because there is really no time to get somewhere else.
The 7th misconception is that you need to be in the wilderness, but obviously I'm right in one of the densest populated area of Norway.
Light pollution doesn't block the northern lights. You can see them from cities. Here at Explore Norway HQ, there is a lot of light pollution, but we can still see them. Here are some pictures taken in the city of Tromsø. However, light pollution prevents your eyes from adapting to the darkness. It takes your pupils about 15 to 20 minutes in complete darkness to fully adapt, and during this time your eyes become much more sensitive to faint light. With street lights around, weak auroras won't be visible at all, and bright ones won't look as impressive. For the best experience, find somewhere dark and give your eyes time to adjust.
The 8th misconception is that you need one of these expensive tours. The reason why you need one is different than you think.
Tours aren't cheap. They cost between 1,300 and 2,100 kroner, roughly 115 euros and 185 euros, per person for a 4 to 6 hour chase. However, this price includes transport to locations outside the city, guides who know where the clouds are clearing, thermal suits, hot food, tripods, and professional photos. If the skies are clear, you can rent a car and drive to a spot outside the city yourself. Car rentals cost around 1,000 to 1,500 kroner per day, cheaper than a tour if you're splitting costs. But here's the problem. If you're not confident driving on snow and ice at night, that tour fee might save you from ending up in a ditch. And during the Aurora season, last-minute car rentals are nearly impossible to find. Booking a tour is no guarantee you'll see the lights, but neither is renting a car.
The 9th and last misconception is that the apps are very accurate.
Although space weather is relatively easy to predict, currently only the general strength can be predicted. It is not possible to predict exactly where an aurora will appear. So you just have to wait outside and stare at the sky. Peak activity is usually between 10 p.m. and 2 a.m. but they can happen anytime after dark. More importantly, you need a weather forecast app. For Norway, ur.no is the best option. They have a special section for the northern lights, which also shows cloud density at the same time.
So that's for today. And if you want to go northern light hunting in Tromsø, check our video about the best spots to see them.